Welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, UK, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are... In India, the BJP has called for the party's return to power in 2019 and the budget session of the parliament has been the least productive since the year 2000. In UK, 80% of firms pay men more than women, and the police are working to reduce street crimes. In Punjab, a loan waiver for farmers from commercial banks has been announced, and the state police is set to become the country's first high-tech department. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com, and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, UK and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are... The BJP has celebrated its 38th Foundation Day across the country, exhorting its cadres to ensure the party's return to power in 2019. It used the occasion to attack opposition parties, especially the Congress, by mocking its efforts to forge a grand alliance for their survival. The budget session of the parliament, which ended on Friday, was the least productive since the year 2000, a legislative research body has said. The ruling BJP and the opposition Congress have blamed each other for the impasse during the session, which saw daily disruptions in both the houses. The Defence Ministry's official website was hacked on Friday, while 9 other government sites, including that of the Home Ministry, also crashed in no time. But the government said that it was all due to a process of technical upgradation and the sites were functioning again by the night. The CBI has questioned RBI's former Deputy Governor Harun Rashid Khan. This is in connection with the 13,500 crore rupees PNB fraud involving Diamond 10 Nirav Modi and his uncle Mehul Choksi. A day earlier, 3 chief general managers and 1 general manager of the central bank were quizzed. India's forex reserves have hit a lifetime high of $424.36 billion after rising by $1.82 billion as on March 30th. Previously, the reserves had touched a record high of $421.914 billion on February 9th. The RBI has asked all payment system operators in the country to store data within India to ensure safety and security of users' information. The move has come at a time when social media giant Facebook has faced a global backlash over breach of user data. India has begun the process to acquire a fleet of around 110 fighter jets. The deal could be one of the world's biggest military procurement in recent years, which is likely to cost more than $15 billion. Nepal Prime Minister KP Oli has made a strong pitch for Indian businessmen to invest in his country by benefiting from its economic liberalisation and being a safe destination for foreign investment. He's on his first foreign trip after returning to power in February. Indian weightlifters continued their highly impressive medal-winning performances with K. Sanjita Chanu and Deepak Lathar clinching the gold and bronze respectively. Squash player Joshna Chinnappa, boxers Amit Pangal and Naman Tanwar entered the quarterfinals at the 21st CWG in Australia. Actress Deepika Padukone says that she would love to explore film production. She finds it fascinating and very exciting. The actress was last seen in the film Padmavat. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from UK and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from UK are... Data published by the Government Equalities Office has revealed that 80% firms pay men more than women. This confirms the long-standing gender inequality at workplaces. Prime Minister Theresa May had last year introduced laws forcing employers to reveal pay gaps between men and women. Commissioner of Met Police Cressida Dick has said that the force has not lost control of London Street despite a ghastly spate of violent crimes. The police are working to reduce street crimes. During the last 7 days, 6 people have been killed due to such crimes. Former Russian spy Sergei Skripal is out of critical condition as he is improving rapidly. He was hospitalized along with his daughter Yulia following a poison attack. The UK has blamed Russia for the attack, which however denied the allegations. Spain Foreign Minister Alfonso Dastis hopes that his country and the UK will reach an agreement over the Gibraltar deal by summer. Spain has a long-standing claim on Gibraltar. However, the UK oversees the territory located on the Iberian Peninsula. Informal talks are on over Gibraltar's post-Brexit future. Labour MP Stephen Kinnock has claimed that the plans for a controversial super prison in Port Talbot have been put on hold. Kinnock's statement came after the Ministry of Justice said that it would remain committed to the proposal. The government has planned a new C-category prison on undeveloped land in Baglan Moors. Labour candidate Alan Bull, who was at the centre of the anti-Semitism controversy, has apologised for the Holocaust Facebook post. Bull was due to stand for election in Peterborough, but faces investigation over a 2015 Facebook post. He said that sharing the post was a bad mistake. Amid the data leak controversy surrounding Cambridge Analytica firm, Facebook will verify identity of people running popular pages. The decision is a part of Facebook's efforts to stem fake news and propaganda. Chief Executive Mark Zuckerberg has backed proposed political ads regulation. The Cambridge College has praised a graffiti of Stephen Hawking on the Cambridge Bridge, which was drawn soon after his death. The graffiti is painted on the land of the Network Rail, which will consider requests of not removing it. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has announced a loan waiver for farmers taken from commercial banks. The announcement came when the state government has waived 156 crore rupees loans taken from cooperative banks. By the end of the year, the government plans to waive loans worth 457 crore rupees. The Punjab Police is set to become the country's first high-tech department with specialized eyewear. It is a pilot project of a Gurgaon-based company. The glasses will recognize a suspect and flash his criminal data on the glass of the screen. Former SAD MLA and BJP leader Chaudhary Mohan Lal Banga has joined the BSP. He stated that he was upset with the BJP's anti-poor and anti-Dalit policies. BSP's Punjab unit in charge, Meghraj, welcomed Banga into the party. Forest Department officials have alleged a scam in the spending of 8.16 crore rupees for the barbed wire fencing around the protected forest areas. A vigilance probe has been demanded into the matter. The fencing was done to keep wild animals away from entering agricultural fields. BSF troopers have killed a Pakistani drug smuggler near the international border in Amritsar district. 4 kilograms of heroin worth 20 crore rupees along with 2 Pakistani SIM cards have been seized. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has stayed the order of the PSEB, terminating 87 daily wagers which was passed last week. The daily wagers have been working in different schools in 6 to 8 years. An order to expunge remarks made against the Vidhan Sabha speaker is unconstitutional. Lok Insaf Party leader Simarjeet Singh Bains has said in a letter to AICC President Rahul Gandhi. He alleged that Speaker Rana KP Singh was working against the stand of the Congress at the national level. The fresh plea filed in the Supreme Court against Cabinet Minister Navjot Singh Sidhu in the 1988 road rage claims that Sidhu had admitted to his guilt during a TV interview in 2010. The latest petition has been filed by the heirs of complainant Jaswinder Singh. Freedom fighter Lab Singh, aged 95, and 3 sons of other freedom fighters carrying petrol in bottles climbed an overhead water tank in the district administrative complex. They raised slogans against the administration and Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh over their long pending demands. The SGPC is set to draft a new recruitment policy following the firing of 523 employees. SGPC Chief Gobind Singh Longwal claimed that there are no specific rules and regulations to recruit employees. The organization termed the earlier recruitment as illegal. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-UK businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
John Abraham's star Parmanu, The Story of Pokhran will now release on May 4th and seems like director Abhishek Sharma is happy as the movie's release now coincides with the same month as the Pokhran test 20 years ago. Now, Abraham shared the teaser of the movie. He took to Twitter the teaser video and wrote, "The biggest secret operation ever that shook the entire nation. Parmanu teaser out now. The nuke explodes in cinemas on 4th May 2018. John's banner earlier announced the termination of a contract with Kriarch Entertainment for Parmanu, The Story of Pokhran, which has been delayed since last year. Parmanu, The Story of Pokhran is an ode to the Indian Army and scientists who, although ordinary people, accomplished truly extraordinary feats in the face of adversity. It salutes, celebrates and truly embraces the slogan Jai Jawan, Jai Vigyan. While the premise of the film is based on true events, the characters are fictitious. The film also features Diana Pendi and Boman Ranani. Miss World Manushi Chiller says that as someone who is living up to a lot of expectations, She didn't feel scared about being compared to successful Bollywood star Kareena Kapoor Khan. Manushi was on Thursday at an event where she was announced the brand ambassador of Malabar Gold and Diamonds. The Haryana-born beauty queen was asked about being compared to the brand's other face, Kareena. She said,
I know that people expect a lot because they have had people like Tamanna Bhatia and Kareena Kapoor Khan. So there are a lot of expectations, but I think for a girl who's already living up to a lot of expectations, I was not very scared. There's more of excitement than nervousness. And like I said, they're different areas. What she has been doing, which she will keep doing, is quite different. And the line of jewelry that I am endorsing is, again, very different.
On her debuting in Bollywood, Manushi said,
Film jaisa ek bada project abhi lena, thoda sa, it's quite dicey. You know, kyunki you have 1 year when you know all you have to do is be a good Miss World, and I want to do justice to the title that has been given to me. इसलिए अभी तो मैंने तभी उस वक्त भी मैंने फिल्मों के बारे में कुछ बोला नहीं और अभी भी मैं कुछ नहीं बोलूँगी क्योंकि right now my focus is completely on different things. ऐसा नहीं है कि मैं सोचती हूँ कि ये मैं शायद ना करूँ या मैं मुझे नहीं करना चाहिए. I think movies are amazing and we've had great actors to be a part of that kind of a pool. I think it's an honor for anyone. पर अभी मैं उसके बारे में सोच नहीं रही हूँ इसलिए मैं आपको बता नहीं सकती इनडेफिनेट व्हाट इज द प्लान.
Manushi is currently traveling from city to city in India and abroad to spread awareness about women's hygiene under the Beauty with Purpose campaign.